Yeah, and they've asked us to differentiate the two types. So mound layering, you got a mother plant and a branch of it is flexible, which is bent to the ground, and the part of the stem is buried in the soil and the tip of the branch is exposed away from the soil. After the root emerges from the plant of the stem, a cut is made in parent plant so that the buried part grows into a new plant. This is about mound layering. You can see it in the picture. The mother plant is there. The branch is bent down and dig deep into the soil and it is buried. So the part which is dug into the buried into the soil forms new roots and grow into a new plant. The second type is going to be hair layering. Here, a part of the stem is grid at nodal region and almonds are applied to this region. And here, the portion is covered by damp or moist soil using a polythene sheet. From this region, after 2 to 4 months, you can find roots and branches emerging from it. Such branches are removed from the parent plant and grown into a separate part or the ground. This is also a very important method which we usually practice in our country sites. You can see in the picture, the nodal regions are removed in the first diagram. The second one, it is dumped with a moist soil. Third diagram, it is covered with a polythene sheet. And after some time, you can find the roots and branches formed in here. Question number 35. List down the advantages of conventional method, that is cutting, grafting, layering. What are the advantages that we get out of this conventional method? The plant produced are genetically uniform. Plants are quickly produced. Some plants are produced in a short period by this method. Some plants can be propagated more economically by vegetative propagation, especially solanum, tuberosum. Two different plants with desirable characters such as disease resistance and high yield can be grafted and grown as a new plant with the same desirable character. What a wonder it is, no? We can produce two different plants, fuse two different plants by the method of a grafting and produce a plant which we need according to our desire. I happen to see a lemon and a pomegranate, a lemon containing inside the pomegranate seeds and it tastes like a lemon. So these are the advantages of the conventional method. We'll move on to question number 36. Explain the conventional methods adapted in vegetative propagation of higher plants. Some of the artificial propagative methods have been used by man for a long time are called as conventional methods. The various conventional methods includes grafting, cutting and the layering. Let's start with the discussion of the cutting. It is a method of producing a new plant by cutting a plant part such as roots, stems and leaf from the parent plant. The cut part is placed in a suitable medium for the growth. It produces roots and grow into new plant. For example, we can take our rose cutting, cutting of the stem, hibiscus cutting, that is what's given there. Stem cutting, hibiscus, bougainvillea, moringa. Moringa is our drumstick plant. So we cut them and plant and let that plant grows into a new one. Grafting, in this part, two different plants are joined so that they continue to grow as one plant. One of the plant is called contact with the soil and it is called the stalk. The other one which we are introducing is called the zygon. Example, citrus, mango, apple. The different types of graftings are given there. The third type is about layering. Layering is a method, the stem of a parent plant is allowed to develop roots while still contact. When the root develops, the rooted part is cut and planted into a new plant. 37th question. Highlight the milestones in the history of plant embryology. So we find more than 13 to 15 scientists who has worked in the field of embryology. You can find this table very well in the first page of your lesson. While reading this content, I want you to, while I taught you the lesson, I told you that you have to put it in a tabular call form. So follow the same pattern, put it in a tabular column method having the year, the name of the scientist and what are the contributions they have made. So that would help you to recollect at times of learning. 38th question, discuss the importance of modern method of reproduction. It's very important. This modern method includes of tissue culture, plant breeding. So what are the advantages? Plants with desirable characters can be produced in a short duration. The plants produced are genetically identical. Tissue cultures can be carried out in any seasons. Plants which do not produce viable seeds, they which find difficult to germinate, can be propagated by tissue culture. Rare and endangered plants can be propagated. Disease-free plants can be produced by meristem culture. Cells can be identically produced, modified and transformed using the tissue culture. These are the various advantages of the modern method of reproduction. 39. Differentiate secretory and invasive tapetum. Tapetum is a wall of the anther. The secretory tapetum retains the original position and cellular integrity and nourishes the developing microspores. Whereas invasive tapetum, they lose their identity and forms a periplasmodium, a colloidal substance in the tapetal wall, in the anther wall. So these are the basic differences. Question number 40. What is canthrophily? It's a very important one, very interesting one. Pollination by the help of beetles. Beetle is a kind of insects. Pollination, if the pollens are transferred by the help of a beetle, then that pollination is called the canthrophily. Question number 41. What is endothelium? The inner layer of the integument may become specialized to perform the nutritive function of the embryo sac, and this is called the endothelium. It is present inside the ovule producing the nutrition. Children, I have discussed with you the part